Issues have grounded a Memphis FedEx worker, and this morning WREG is helping to pass it on.
WREG's Richard Ransom shows us how his life was turned upside down in just a matter of hours.
Playmaker Christina Vasquez is worried about a family she's known for years.
Just this family is just means a lot to me, and they're just really good people and in a hard time right now, so just want to help them out.
What sparked Christina's concern was a Christmastime injury to Dan Wheely, a decades-long welder for FedEx. Dan now faces early retirement because the injury triggered a fast-spreading infection related to his diabetes called necrotizing fasciitis. He was rushed to the hospital several weeks ago and is still there. The flesh-eating disease took away most of Dan's leg. He was having his fifth surgery the day we met Christina at the New Methodist Hospital in Olive Branch.
Why so many surgeries?
They're just making sure that they're getting everything that they need to get, make sure everything looks good before they decide that they're going to close them up. The doctor's just erring on the side of caution, I guess, so it's hard.
But despite how quickly Dan and his family's lives have changed, Christina says Dan's attitude is helping everyone cope.
He seems to be doing very well. He, spirits are high, family's always around. He's the kind of person that's going to crack a joke no matter what anyway.
There's nothing funny about saying goodbye to FedEx after more than 30 years, and nothing easy about paying for the many expenses from such a long hospital stay not covered by insurance. Time to pass it on.
Hi, Christina. I've got $600 on a very windy day, so hold on to the money tight for you to pass it on to Dan and Marilyn. There's one.
$300 from WREG and the rest from a Collierville doctor and his wife who want to stay anonymous.
It's a lot. It's going to be a good help. I can't even explain my feelings right now. Like, I'm so excited.
good. Well, let's get her down here, all right?
Christina has worked out a plan.
Since he's in surgery, we're planning on getting his wife down here and just surprise her. She has no idea, so hopefully she takes it well.
Dan's wife, Marilyn, is about to come through those sliding glass doors.
Come on. Yes. Come on.
Once we make introductions, Christina counts off the cash.
I'm Richard Ransom.
Okay, so we have $600 for you. You gotta hold your hand out.
Oh my God.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Thank you so much.
I think
Thank
that this
you.
Will help.
I think it will too.
You could see the relief on Marilyn's face.
Yeah. It means a lot. I'm going through a lot right now. Yeah. So.
But with friends like Christina, passing it on can make all the difference.
It meant everything to me just because I know that they're just going through this hard time, and I just wanted to be able to help.
Richard Ransom, WREG News Channel 3.
Well, here's some positive news here. At last check, Christina says doctors now feel that they have gotten ahead of this terrible infection, and soon Dan will be ready to go to rehab.
He's been through so much.
Yeah,
let's hope that happens
a lot,
soon.
Hope that goes well for him and his family.
The giver just as emotional as the receiver today.
It's usually that
way. There's so much joy in giving.
It is. You know, I was just about to ask our audience the same thing. Don't you feel great when you're able to give and help out somebody like that and realize what a big difference that's going to make for them? You know, in the Mid-South today, all what I can say is have the umbrella handy. Just follow Mark Hove and Stephanie's lead. They've already got their umbrellas handy. They've been listening. They've been paying attention. I've been telling you all week long we have some rain trying to move into the area. Now, granted, we have been talking about the rainfall. Do you remember earlier this week we talked about that big volcano
down in Mexico?
In Mexico, yes. Well, there's another one. Today there are two volcanoes. The Colima volcano has now joined the Don Goyo volcano. Yesterday alone, it registered several explosions. Take a look at this, all right? Now, the Don Goyo volcano in central Mexico continues to be very active as well. Yesterday, it spewed ash more than a mile up into the sky. It also registered more than 130 explosions, and I have a feeling those are like mini earthquakes. You're going to be feeling those for quite some distance. But what a sight that is. Two volcanoes erupting right now down in Mexico. Okay, we're starting off with some cloud cover in the area, but so far so good. Our weather has been very quiet, and First Defense Doppler 3D radar will continue to scan the skies, going in search of any problems. Our problems will begin with the rain arriving from the west later today. This is going to be the cold front getting ready to move into the area, but you'll remember it doesn't get here until until after lunchtime, so you're doing pretty good this morning. But if you can keep that in the back of your mind, what do I need to do to plan and prepare for rainfall later this afternoon and on the way home? And we talked to Markov and Stephanie a moment ago. They have the umbrellas, they have the boots, they've got everything ready just in case. We're looking at about a quarter of an inch of rain as this fast-moving front moves across the area, bringing about a quarter of an inch later today. We are talking temperatures near 60. It is very mild this morning all across the area. Why? Gusting southerly winds. Those winds are going to be gusting 25 to 30 miles an hour, and that strong southerly flow really keeps our temperatures up. So we're going to bottom out in the mid-50s this morning and quickly see our temperatures turn around. Winds are going to be gusting. Showers are going to be kicking in around midday, so between about noon and 3 o'clock is when we'll see our best chance for showers and thundershowers. But do you remember how I mentioned that this front is moving very quickly? That's why the rainfall amounts are going to be minimal, with the exception of some isolated thundershower activity where you could pick up brief heavy downpours. Most of us are only looking at about a quarter of an inch of rain. Starts around midday. We'll move across West Tennessee through the early afternoon. And by the time we get to this evening and you're going to be watching News Channel 3 on TV tonight before going to bed, you will notice the sky is beginning to clear and the northerly winds kicking back in. Now, wrapping into an area of low pressure to the north brings us a few more clouds on Thursday, but I'm not looking at any significant precipitation. It's just part of the clearing process coming in behind that front. So watch these temperatures. They really don't change all that much. We climb through the upper 60s, lower 70s. The rain rolls in this afternoon, moves out this evening, and we will drop down into the 40s by daybreak tomorrow, but recover right back up into the upper 60s to near 70 throughout the course of the afternoon tomorrow. So on the 7-day forecast, the cold front's the big weather news today, with the rain and thunder chances rather breezy, but continued mild. We're in the upper 60s again tomorrow. More sunshine, cooler conditions for your Friday and Saturday, the highs closer to 60. And while the weekend looks fantastic, the 10-day outlook includes an increased chance for some rain once again on Monday and Tuesday of next week. So it looks like it's going to be a pretty good start to the day, but we do have rain for this afternoon that you need to be prepared for. I'll continue to track that front and keep you updated.
Good Wednesday morning, everyone. This Time Saver Traffic Report is brought to you by ATC Fitness. Right now, we do have a disabled vehicle blocking the center lane over at Shelby Drive in Sweeney. So it's going to be on Shelby Drive heading westbound at Sweeney, blocking that center lane. So causing a bit of a delay for motorists if you normally head in that direction in the next 10-15 minutes on Shelby Drive at Sweeney. Also, Audi's 58 miles per hour starting to see it kind of slow down as you're approaching the flyover and taking the north leg of I-40. And here's a live look from our TDOT SmartWay cam, just kind of gauging the flow traffic over on Bill Morris Parkway, merging nicely so far onto the south leg of I-240. Flow traffic looking fantastic in all directions. I'm Corey Ventura with your WREG News Channel 3 Time Saver Traffic.